to our channel, Automate.Tech. In this video, you will learn about what is sensor fusion and how it works in an autonomous vehicle system. If you haven't watched the previous videos on autonomous vehicles, click the link provided in the description. In autonomous vehicles, individual shortcomings of each sensor type cannot be overcome by just using the same sensor type multiple times. Instead, it requires combining the information coming from different types of sensors. A camera CMOS chip working in the visible spectrum has trouble in dense fog, rain, sun glare, and the absence of light. Radar lacks the high resolution of today's imaging sensors, and so on. You can find strengths and weaknesses like that for each sensor type. The great idea of sensor fusion is to take the inputs of different sensors and sensor types and use the combined information to perceive the environment more accurately. That results in better and safer decisions than independent systems could do. For example, radar might not have the resolution of light-based sensors, but it is great for measuring distances and piercing through rain, snow, and fog. These conditions or the absence of light do not work well for a camera, but it can see color, think street signs and road markings, and has a great resolution. We have 1-megapixel image sensors on the street today. In the next few years the trend will be 2 and even 4 megapixels. Radar and camera are examples of how two sensor technologies can complement each other very well. In this way, a fused system can do more than the sum of its independent systems could. Using different sensor types can in addition offer a certain level of redundancy to environmental conditions that could make all sensors of one type fail. That failure or malfunction can be caused by natural, such as a dense fog bank, or man-made phenomenon, for instance spoofing or jamming a camera or radar. Such a sensor-fused system could maintain some basic or emergency functionality, even if it lost a sensor. With purely warning functions, or the driver always being ready and able to take over control, a system failure might not be as critical. However, highly and fully autonomous functions must allow adequate time to give control back to the driver. A minimum level of control needs to be maintained by the control system during this time span. The goal of sensor fusion is to leverage the complementary strengths of the sensing modalities while canceling out their weaknesses. With recent advances in deep learning, two paradigms of sensor fusion have emerged. In late fusion processes, each sensing modality independently work until the very end, using probabilistic techniques to fuse them in the final stages. Early fusion leverages recent advances in deep learning, using neural networks to fuse the raw sensor reading in the early stages. In the next video, we will learn about the various terms used in autonomous vehicles. So, we have come to the end of the video. Like us and subscribe for more videos.